Hello, internet friend, and welcome to this video today where I'm going to show you how to create an invoice in MYOB or MYOB or mind your own business. I'm not sure why MYOB is MYOB, but it is. So let's sign in. I've got MYOB Essentials and I'm just going to go and log in here. That's the first step, obviously. TGuard 1993, stay signed in for 12 hours. Okay, here we go. So the first thing we want to do is go to sales and we want to go to create invoice. From here, a page like this will pop up. So from the customer list, you will have all of the customers that you've had in MYOB before. If you're doing this for a new customer, you can click here and say add customer, and you can go through the steps of adding a new customer. But in this case, I'm actually lodging a real invoice today. So I'm gonna be charging Webwise Pty Ltd. And you'll see here, an invoice number pops up. Purchase order, you can fill that in if it's applicable to you. Here we've got the due date. So the way I work when I'm working with this company in particular is I make the due date within 2 days of the invoice date. So I'm going to put 2 days. And what this will do here is automatically keep this number 2 days longer or 2 days further ahead than the date of issue. So if the date of issue is the 25th and I put due 2 days from invoice date, it'll make it the 27th. Now, it is Wednesday the 25th that I'm doing this. I should have done this invoice yesterday. So I'm actually gonna make the date of issue the 24th and the due date for this invoice will be the 26th, okay? Amounts are GST inclusive. If you are in Australia and you earn over, I think, $70,000 a year, you do have to apply for GST. I am registered for GST, so I'm going to put GST inclusive. Okay, so the next part is to select our items and descriptions and where we're going to allocate it, how many units there were, what the price of the unit was. So in this instance, I've got two items that I usually bill for. I've got video promotion where I do social media stuff, or I've got management services. So when I'm working for Webwise, I, you know, handle all of their systems administration. I also help manage the team in terms of upkeep of those systems. So that's what I'm billing for today. And then what will happen here is it'll automatically decide what it wants to allocate as. Now, I'm a company and I put this under fee income because that's, you know, the income that my company's getting. The hours, I'm going to say I worked 33 at $50 an hour and GST inclusive. So you'll see here that it automatically calculates, okay, well, if you've put GST inclusive, you've put it on the invoice, $150 is 10% of $1,650, okay? And that's how I'd go about putting my invoice together. I make sure my own bank details are present with my account number and stuff. And then I wanna email it. So what I'll do from here, you pretty much have a templated version of the invoice. So it'll say, here's my invoice, please pay it by blah, 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 and all good. Now, I may have more attachments, like I might have a timesheet where I clock in and clock out. I don't know what your system's like, but I don't ever have to do that. I also make sure I CC a copy to my work email for that client, and then I just send the invoice. Shablamo. And then what will happen is when you come back into your sales tab and you go to invoices, it'll show you that your latest invoice is sitting there. It'll say, the total amount that's owing, it'd say the total amount that's due, it'll give you the invoice dates. And when that invoice gets paid, in my transaction section, it'll pop up and say, hey, you've been paid $1,650 from Webwise. And then what I'll do is I'll reconcile that transaction with this particular invoice based on the date that it was paid. And then we're off. And that's how you create an invoice. And also your outstanding invoices do appear on your homepage. So see here how we've got a green current, this green circle. Well, green means current invoices owing, but not yet overdue. Yellow is 1 to 30 days overdue. And obviously as you get further down the track, it, you know, if you get to 61 days and haven't been paid, that's a bit of a problem, but you know. So yeah, if you've got any questions regarding this, I use MYOB all the time. I use it for all of my business tax. I use it for all my invoicing. And I actually quite like this system. Also being like a one-man band with a company, it makes managing a company with single touch payroll and all that kind of stuff a lot more simple. So yeah, if you've got any more MYOB questions, more than happy to help you out with that. Just leave me a comment in the comment section and make sure you give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful today. Okay, I'll see you in the next tech video. Bye.